Hello friends, welcome back to Neet with Bioscience. Let us continue our discussion on beta oxidation of fatty acid. In the previous two classes, we had discussed about the beta oxidation of fatty acid, and especially in the last class, we had discussed about the beta oxidation of saturated fatty acid. Fatty acid are present in the both form, saturated as well as unsaturated. Saturated fatty acid means no double bond is present in the fatty acid chain, and unsaturated fatty acid means the double bond is there. So because of the double bond, that is known as the unsaturated fatty acid. So we had discussed the beta oxidation of saturated fatty acid in the last class. In today's class, we will see the beta oxidation of unsaturated fatty acid. Unsaturated fatty acid, again, these are of two types: monounsaturated fatty acid and polyunsaturated fatty acid, MUFA and PUFA, monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fatty acids. So let us see how this beta's oxidation of this fatty acid is different from that of the saturated fatty acid. So first we will just quickly review the how saturated fatty acid oxidation takes place. There are four steps which we have to remember, because that is mostly asked in the MCQs. So those are four major steps: are dehydrogenation, hydration, dehydrogenation and thiolysis. That is the four major steps of beta oxidation of saturated fatty acids. Okay, so first step, suppose this is dehydrogenation. Second is the hydration. Here, if you look at carefully, the product is trans delta 2 enoin CoA. Okay, so on this product, enoyl CoA hydrate will act, and hydration means addition of the one water molecule takes place. So key difference is here, trans. What is trans? Let us, we all know, but still we will mention here what is trans, cis and trans. There are two terms. So suppose if in a fatty acid chain on the double bond, where there is a carbon-carbon double bond, if the hydrogen atom attached to the carbon atom which is involved in the double bond, if it is in the same side of the double bond, if it is same side, then it is known as a cis form, and if it is in the opposite side, then it is known as a trans form. Okay, so in terms of the saturated fatty acid, after dehydrogenation, there is a formation of the trans delta 2 enoyl CoA, and upon that this enzyme will work. But most of the unsaturated fatty acids which are present in the triglyceride, phospholipids, which is obtained from the plant and animal sources, these are present in a cis form. Naturally, all naturally occurring fatty acids, triglyceride, phospholipid, in which they are present in the cis form. Okay, so there is a slight variation of the oxidation of this fatty acids, unsaturated fatty acid, because these are present, naturally present in the cis form. So there is a slightly difference from that of this pathway, and two enzymes are majorly, two main enzymes are involved here, that is isomerase and reductase. Okay, so because of the presence of these two enzymes, there is a slight variation of oxidation of unsaturated fatty acid as compared to saturated fatty acids. So we had discussed that there are two type of unsaturated fatty acids: monounsaturated fatty acid if the one double bond is there, and polyunsaturated fatty acid means if it is more than one double bond. So mono and poly. So if it is oxidation of monounsaturated fatty acids, so only the isomerase enzyme is involved. Means in a complete cycle, only the difference here is of isomerase. And if it is a polyunsaturated, so both these enzymes are involved in the oxidation of polyunsaturated fatty acids. So let us discuss the oxidation of mono and poly one by one. So first we will see the oxidation of monounsaturated fatty acid. Okay. So now let us first we will discuss the beta oxidation of monounsaturated fatty acid. So in monounsaturated fatty acid, let's take the example of the oleic acid. Oleic acid, it is a 18 carbon compound. Okay. So if you remember, while discussing the beta oxidation of saturated fatty acids, what we had discussed, the site where the beta oxidation takes place, it is in the mitochondria of the cell. Okay, so first fatty acid has to travel from the cytoplasm into mitochondria. Okay, and there is one shuttle system is there, that is known as a carnating shuttle system. So same thing will take place here. Okay, oleic acid also, the first it will activated and the transferred into mitochondria, and we will get the oleoyl CoA. Okay, and then as we had discussed that due to the presence of the double bond which is in the cis configurations, there is a slight difference, but the oleic acid, the double bond, it is present at the between the 9th and the 10th positions. So before that, it is like a saturated fatty acid, because the problem is coming here at the 9th position. No? So before that, it is like a saturated fatty acid. So three cycles of the beta oxidation will take place as that of saturated fatty acid, and we will get the 3-acetyl coenzyme. Okay, three cycle between, means in every cycle, two carbon atoms will be removed. So this way, three cycle, first, second and the third, three cycle of beta oxidation will take place like saturated fatty acid, and we will get 3-acetyl coenzyme A, and the product form, which is the 12 carbon compound, that is cis delta 3 dodecanoyl CoA, cis delta 3, because now the double bond, see, after breaking, now numbering will start from here, because 6 carbon has removed in the 3 beta oxidation cycle. So now we will get the 12 carbon compound, first, second, third and fourth. So now the double bond is present between the third and the fourth, which is in the cis configuration. So on this product, delta 3 delta 2 enoyl CoA isomerase will act, which will shift the double bond, or which will isomerize in, this product into transform from the cis form. So see, originally the double bond was present between the third and the fourth carbon, now it is present between the second and the third carbon. This will shift like this. So now it will present between the second and the third third positions, and it is in the transform. One hydrogen is here, another is here. So we had just discussed what is transform. If the hydrogen atom is present on the opposite side of the double bond, then it is a transform. So now it has converted into transform. Name is a trans delta 2 dodecanoyl CoA delta 2, because double bond is at the second positions. Again, this is a 12 carbon compound, like earlier with this product, that is cis delta 3 dodecanoyl CoA. Now it is a trans delta 2 dodecanoyl CoA. Only the isomerization means the shifting of the double bond from the cis to trans positions, and between second and the third carbon. And now again, five more cycles of the beta oxidation will take place. Okay, and finally we will get the 6-acetyl CoA, because five cycles and one acetyl CoA will remain at the last two. So therefore 5 plus 1, that is the 6-acetyl CoA we will get, and this acetyl CoA will then enter into the Krebs cycle or TCA cycle. Okay, so this way, this is the beta oxidation of monounsaturated fatty acid. Example is the oleic acid. Are you getting what is happening in the oleic acid? Cis double bond is present at the 9th position. So the first till the double bond, 3 cycle will take place, 3-acetyl CoA will be removed, then cis bond will come, so isomerase will come, isomerase will do the isomerization from cis to trans. If once we will get the transform, 5 more cycle will take place, and ultimately we will get the 6-acetyl CoA, means total 9-acetyl CoA will get in the beta oxidation of oleic acid, or which is monounsaturated fatty acid. Are you getting? Now in the next class, we will see the beta oxidation of the polyunsaturated fatty acid. In that example is the linoleic acid. Okay. So, we will meet in the next class. Okay. Thank you.